Welcome to another episode of 3DIY.
Today, we're going to be talking about 3D printer file types.
That's right, a 3D printer file carries the information from the CAD model designed on a computer like this one here to the 3D printer.
Everyone who wants to 3D print something with them will use them.
It's kind of like a blueprint.
Today, we'll be talking about the two most commonly used, the STL and the OBJ.
STL stands for Standard Tessellation Language. That's because an STL is a shape formed using triangles.
This was the first file type invented for 3D printing, which means it has a lot of community support for troubleshooting and tutorials and designs that you can download just like this.
The STL is simple, but old. It carries a lot of useless information, making it bloated and slow. And it also can't print in color, since that technology didn't exist at the time.
For that kind of stuff, you need an OBJ file format, like this one here. And another benefit, the OBJ also maintains scaling information and uses freeform curves to use precision rather than just triangles.
It stores this information on an MTL carriage file. However, a broken MTL is harder to fix on an OBJ than it is with an STL, and MTLs can be easily lost.
But there are ways to avoid this problem. Thanks for joining us for another episode of 3DIY.
And that concludes our presentation on the two main file types of 3D printing, the STL and the OBJ.
Join us next week, where we implant a microchip into Eric's hand.
What?
Beep.
For more information, check the links in the description below.
Researchers, we understand during these uncertain times, you still need digital research skill support while working from home.
We have been working hard behind the scenes to present to you an online digital skills support pack. This includes our Tech Tools Online e-learning videos,
self-paced online learning modules, and community initiatives like virtual help hours.
And to keep informed of our content and more updates, follow us on our socials.